Hey, this is Chris Menard. If you've never used Excel and you've never used Excel functions, I'm going to run you through some simple business functions that you will need for the rest of your life. I'm going to walk you through this. It'll be really simple. These are all great functions. I use them all the time, and it's a great starting point if you've never done functions in Excel. I'll also explain the difference between a formula and a function. Let's go ahead and dive in right now. So go ahead and start Excel. If a blank workbook doesn't open up, go to File, New, or Control and the letter N. I'm going to go from scratch on this exercise. Item number one, just to make this a little bit bigger, in the bottom right, I'm going to go ahead and change my zoom by hitting the plus symbol two or three times. So I want to keep up with how many orders we have from different countries. So up in A1, put in the word country. I'm going to make up countries. Let's start off with Japan, then United States. Just press enter after you type in these names. Let's do Spain, France, one more country. Let's do the UK. So I've got five countries listed. Go to cell B1. You can either use the arrows or you can click in B1 with the mouse. This is your name box over here to the left. It's always telling you what cell you're in. I want to keep up with orders. I'm going to keep these numbers really simple. For Japan, let's do 20. The United States was 40. Spain was 30. France was 70. And the UK was 90. Perfect. Not required, but I always encourage you to highlight what is called your header row. A1 and B1 are your header row fields. I'm going to click on A1, pull over to B1, and hit the B for bold. This is just me, and it's just a matter of preference. I'm going to select cell B1 because I've got numbers below it. And in the alignment group, I'm going to align orders to the right. I just find it easier to read. So all we've done is typed in some countries, put in the orders, and made our header row bold. Let's now jump into some functions. But before we do the functions, I want to explain the difference between a formula versus a function. Here is a formula. Feel free just to watch me do this. If I do equal B2 plus B3 plus B4 plus B5 plus B6, that answer is correct. It is 250. But the function that we're going to end up doing is called the sum function. I would want to sum up cell B2 through cell B6. I'm going to get the exact same answer. I did Control Enter. So I'll catch you up in just 1 second. But here's cell B8 is a formula. It is no words are involved. I added up a bunch of cells. I could have multiplied or divided. Doesn't matter. Cell B9 is an Excel function. It is the sum function. It is built into Excel, already in here. The big difference is always use a function over a formula if there is a function. Sometimes you'll have to just do a formula. The reason is this. If I insert and forgot about a country, and I'm just going to type in the number over here, 100, enter. Notice that the 250 is inaccurate. That is the formula we did, but my Excel function picked up the 100. I'm going to do an undo, and I'm back here with you. So use a function when available, and let's dive into some functions right now. These are all what I consider business functions. I use these every day. I'm going to go to cell A8 and type in the word total, and then press the tab key. The tab key will move you to the right. Make sure you're in cell B8. I want to total up these orders. I'm currently using the home tab up in the top left corner. Over to the far right are my groups, clipboard, font, alignment, they're all at the bottom, but when I get to the right, I've got what's called the editing group. Inside the editing group is the most popular function in Excel, the sum function, it says auto sum. Click it one time. It's going to sum up B2 through B7. It is okay that you've got that blank. That blank is not going to mess you up. Just click auto sum again. Perfect. Do it again. Click auto sum once. If you don't want to click it a second time, you can press enter. 250 is correct. One more time, click on the 250. This time, press the delete key on your keyboard. It is above the arrows. If you're a keyboard person, auto sum is alt equal with the keyboard. And then just press enter. 250 is correct. There's your first Excel function. Let's keep going though. I want to know what's the average. I'm going to abbreviate average AVG. If you want to spell it out, you can. Hit the tab key. I'm over in cell B9. Same group, the editing group. Don't click auto sum. Click the drop down arrow next to auto sum. There is average. They put some of the most popular Excel functions on this drop down arrow. I'm going to select average. Excel does not know what to do, so it picked up the 250, which is cell B8. That is incorrect. Grab your mouse, click right in the middle of the 20, that is cell B2, and don't let go and pull straight down. If you want to include the blank, you can, and I do. So I'm going to pull down to cell B7. Now I'm letting go of the mouse. I'm going to do the average of cells B2 through B7. Press enter. And the average is 50. That is correct. If you click on the 50 in cell B9, this is called the formula bar right up here. If you just leave your mouse up here, it'll say it. You don't need to click there. Just point up here and it'll say the formula bar. That was two functions. Let's do another one. The third function I'm going to do, this is why Excel is so cool and people start realizing, oh, this is really going to benefit me. I could have grabbed my smartphone, used the calculator and got the 250, and then taken the 250 and divided by 5 to get the 50, which is the average. No problem. Could have used my phone, could have used an adding machine, whatever. But I want to know now in cell A10, what is the highest? Type in the word highest. Tab over. So always click where you want your answer. We happen to be in cell B10. Drop down arrow by auto sum in the editing group, and there is the max function. The max function is going to give you the highest value. Click it once. Same as with average, it doesn't know what to do. Select cell B2. Don't let go when you click it. Drag down to cell B7. Now you can let go of the mouse. I'm trying to figure out what's the maximum value from cell B2 to B7. Press enter. You should definitely get the number 90. There you go. Opposite of the max function. I'm going to do the word lowest. That is my label in cell A11. Hit tab. Opposite of max, drop down, M-I-N. Click it one time. Same steps. Highlight B2 to cell B7. Press enter, and there you go. We've done four functions already. What is cool about the last two that I did, can't do those with my calculator on my smartphone. That is why Excel is so cool. Keep going with these. I want to type in and figure out what is the second highest. Second highest tab. If you wanted to spell out the word second, you could have. But notice that the text went over into column B. We're going to use the auto fit feature in Excel. I've got a whole section on this, but for right now, put your mouse between column A and column B and double click real quick. That is an auto fit. All the functions we've done, we basically have used the mouse. I'm going to redo one of them. And I'm going to do it with the keyboard, and then I'm going to come figure out the second highest. Let's go do the max again, the number 90. Press the delete key. Don't use the mouse. Just type equal M-A-X. I need to put in an open parenth. You can do shift in the number 9 but I find it easier just to press the tab key. The tab key will do the open parenth. What cell range do you want? B2 colon B7. I'm going to figure out the max of B2 through B7. You do not have to close the parenth. Excel will do it for you, but if you want to, it'd be Shift 0. I'm going to backspace and leave it open. Go ahead and do Control Enter on your keyboard. Control Enter leaves you in the same cell. Enter would have moved me down one. Control Enter just leaves me here. Look up in your formula bar, right above for me, column C, equals max, open parenth, B2 through B7, and it's closing it for me. Perfect. So we typed that one all the way. Now, I always love to ask this question when I'm in training. Did you prefer doing that with the mouse, or did you prefer the keyboard? I get a lot of people that say they just love the mouse, and that is fine with me. I love the mouse too. What I want to make sure you know is you can type these, because one day you'll be looking for the max function that we just did. But instead of B2 to B7, it may be cell B2 to cell B498,000. That is a long way to go with the mouse. So just make sure you know you can type these in here. We are going to type the next one. I'm looking for the second highest. Go to cell B12. This Excel function, again, is one of my favorites. I use it all the time. It is the large function. So the max function will give you the highest number, but I'm looking for the second highest. Equal, press the letter L, press the letter A, press the letter R. The minute you see large, you can hit tab. You don't have to keep typing. I happen to see it on my screen right now. It is highlighted in blue. I'm going to press tab. If you're a mouse person and you don't want to hit tab, put your mouse on the word large and double click it. There's the open parent too. What is your range? I'm going to go ahead and use the mouse. B2 through B7. This function has two arguments. All the other functions we have done have had one. Sum, average, max, min had one argument. This one's got two, meaning I need to add a comma, B2 colon B7 comma, because I need to specify what large I'm looking for. I'm looking for the second. So I'm gonna put in the number two. If I was looking for the third, I would have done comma three. Control Enter. By the way, you should get the number 70. And we did. And again, there is our formula bar, large B2 colon B7 comma 2. Two more. Opposite of the second highest is the second lowest. I'm going to just go ahead and type equal small, SMA. Hit tab if it's selected, B2 colon B7, comma 2. These functions, when you type them in, notice, are not case sensitive. I did a little letter B and a little for B2 and a little B for B7. I could have typed in caps. But when you're done typing, Control Enter, and you look in the formula bar, it'll always convert them to uppercase. So therefore everything's uppercase here. So our lowest number was 20. That was Japan. And the second lowest is 30, which is Spain. So this is working correctly. One more function. I love this function. We did the average, but I also want to know what is the median. Type in the word median in cell A14 and then tab over to B14. The median function will find the middle value. It internally sorts the numbers, so it's going to sort those five numbers, and it's going to return the middle value, which, looking at those numbers, I'm just doing this in my head, should be the number 40. It goes 20, 30, 40, 70, 90. Five numbers. What's the middle one? The third one is 40. Equal MED, tab, grab your mouse, highlight them, feel free to include the blank in B7. Just press enter and see if you get 40, Perfect. Feel free to click it and look in the formula bar. In case you're wondering, I had 5 numbers to pull from, so it found the middle number. But if you have an even number of numbers, like number 6, 8, 24, it'll take the 2 middle numbers and figure out the average, and that will be your median number. That was great. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell, and I'll see you soon.